officiating. I know people talk about officiating as it's a tough gig. It really is not good out for everybody. I'm at a higher level, so the higher you go, the easier the game is to officiate. But you have to be spot on when you pass. Make sense? Lower level, running around, is this traveling when you're doing this, you're trying to pass the ball? No. Right? If you're in a third grade game and they're doing this, if they start at the top of the key, right? They start here and they're doing this, walking all the way in, yeah, call it a tap. But if they're all going to be sleeping for something to pass, talk to them, hey, pass the ball. You gotta communicate when you're working with the shorties, right? When they get a ball, they're shooting, line them up, because they ain't gonna know how to line themselves up. That was smart. Okay, so, and I think the drive is coming from the parent side just as well, right? They're becoming more understanding that you can't just yell out to a court, hey, that's a horrible call, it's just a status quo. That's always gonna happen, regardless of where you are. If you walk in tonight, they're gonna yell at you. It just it comes with the territory. You got a thick skin, you gotta block things out, right? You're the one awareness starts, you're the one going to whistle, you're the one that is making the call. So don't worry about anything other than the players that are on the floor. The safety is the number one concern for players, for coaches and for players. Don't let rough play happen. Right? And if the coach has a question, answer the question and you get back to it. Right? It's about being matter of fact in what you're doing. You got your comment, being a crystal will turn you into a leader. Because when you blow your whistle, everybody goes, right? You got your fist off, there's a violation, whatever it is. Right? Just be matter of fact with your stuff. So again, it's turn. My name is Tony Schmeck, I'm the director of officials at the MYAS. I've been an official for over 30 years. My multiple sports, probably the rest of you guys. I was with the high school program. I had to talk to Tony's. He was a past coach, the head coach. Probably he's got a son. He's not going to get it. That's all I'm at. I've been on it, so I don't know. I work with college basketball. Right now I'm doing soccer at state tournament. Welcome on the Sullivan State. And baseball and basketball this summer. It's great. I love being an official because it keeps me in shape, it keeps me youthful because I get to hang out with a bunch of young people. So I gotta travel and stay in shape and be ready to go. Because every year, players get 1 year older, they all stay the same age, right? I get 1 year older, but every college kid is 18 to 22 every year. They're all there, they're 1 year older, so I'm going to try to stay in shape, right? And it's a great way to stay in shape. Again, knowing the rules, communication, hustle, right? Those are three key factors to being in shape. Dressing the car. Dress appropriately, right? Don't be looking like a slob, shirt top, make sure everything is in order, right? Hair's done, you've got a clean uniform, you look steady. Because you're earning credibility as an official. Everything you do as an official is about earning credibility with the players, the coaches, and the fans. Don't give them any reason to doubt you. You're just going to walk around like this. And you're going to stand here, and you're going to play out here and come on, and blow the whistle. That's not going to be your credibility. It's not. If they're walking the ball up, because they're dribbling and he's calling out the play, we're running too. He's dribbling. Right? He's going to roll out. So they're going to draw it up. They're running. Run. Don't be that lazy official that is not going to cross the path forward. And when you do, you go right to here, and this is all as far as you go. Oh, green, look, there you are, so I'm running. You want to see it? It's way outside of the 3-point arc. This is where your trail officer should be working. don't got on the internet court. And these courts are small. A lot of courts are working on these shorter courts. A college court will play that, and there's just 16 feet in between, so you're going to be doing some money. So if you don't like money, you may not want to be a lawyer. And you do more running than basketball than doing soccer. One would think you could be a lawyer, because if you're going, it's fast pace. So within our program, some of this stuff is geared for our in-person training. So you are going to have your in-person training done. This is working for the Waconia community, right? And if you wanted to join the MYAS and do other tournaments around town, I know they host some at the high school. You can go over to Jam, which is kind of close. Even Perry's pretty close. I mean, there's a lot of places you can work. Besides working for Derek and the Waconia community. So if other people by all means, you'll have done an in-person training. What I'll do is I'll send, after this is done, I have a list of everybody that on that email list. I'll send you a link to register for the MYAS. And that will give you more opportunity to work on the weekends. Derek, are the games being played on weekends or is it weekday stuff?
They're all Saturdays.
All Saturdays? Yep. Okay, so we can fill you up on Sunday if you want to do Sunday as well. Right? Your 4-game set, 25 Sunday. When I started, we were making 10 bucks. But a bag of Doritos and Orange Crush was like 75 cents. And it was a little bit more. So, cost of living takes a while. But it's still a really good thing. Everybody that does these clinics are officials. Officials working for officials. You guys are becoming officials. Have fun with us. Smile. Work hard. Enjoy yourself. Talk to the players. When a player does something like great, say, hey, number 12, that was a great shot. Great skill, whatever. When you get the opportunity. Because that goes a long way to you when you get good. Right? There's a bunch of things that go into the MYAS. We'll go through a little touch base on something and then we'll get into the hours. We'll go through some of this pretty quick. If you have questions about how it's asked, please ask. Stop me and ask. Okay? Basketball is an important basketball position. Proper position mechanics, points of emphasis, effective communication, interpretation, application of the rule. Working with different partners because you want to always work with the same person. If you do, great. Gives you that vision continuity and consistency. Situational awareness. Some things that a lot of people talk about is nutrition and rest and mental health. And if you have to have it, this being an official puts you under some pressure. Ready? You've got to be ready for the pressure because it's coming. So, I know we talked about Arbor. We're going to Arbor just as well, so you'll have that. I'm on Arbor with like 20 times. NCAA, MYAS, UMAC, WYAC, the high school, all that stuff is on Arbor. So once you do one, a lot of stuff will just transfer over. If I register for high school, they all have to take care of all my students. And then I just do my test and module for that school. So, and make sure you're up to date. I didn't talk about blocking out dates. Look at your calendar, look ahead. And I know things pop up, or hey, I can't make it to, you know, today's Monday, we're supposed to work tomorrow, and something came up. They call them, let them know, hey, I can't make it tomorrow. This is where I'm at, and this is the things I have. Right? So, be good at doing that stuff, because that is your best thing. That's availability, isn't it? The more you get out here, the easier it becomes. It's like anything, right? None of us know the tire shoes, and I still don't know the tire shoes that we are. But you learn how to do it. And it's a reputation. It's like you guys have to do this work. Yes. Make sure you get the name and do it the right way. So, phone number, get a picture of yourself. You know, not one of you might want to ask for a picture of your dog. Get a picture of you, try to make a profession. You should have high school. Those are always good. If you can get a picture of a photo, get it on there. It just shows that you have. you get to your game, you have a series of games. Make sure you do it 20 minutes before your first game, your first scheduled game of the day. You start every game, so you can either no later than the second quarter. That way you can talk. You know, you're talking about the game. This is what we're going to do today, whatever it is, right? You're looking the same, but just the same. All those things. And start that email the night before. Because when they assign you, you're going to see that it's myself and you work and everything, if you have a email, you have a cell phone. Say, hey, this is going up, we have a 7:30, right? We've got 4 days, 4 months, whatever it is. Start that chain so you have that going. So in case you are going to be late, right? Whatever, you don't have to try to look up a person. You can just go, oh, it's already in there, and I can just click, call and text. Let them know that you need to do whatever it is. So, again, that's just business. Again, you're going to go over your free vehicle, talking about what you want to do for the day. Right? One person's going to throw the job, the other one will be the new leader, and keep going. All those things, right? Game management's huge, right? You're managing game, that's what you do. Because everybody in the stands can say, that's a foul, that's a violation. What you're doing is you're managing the game within the game, right? You touch base on it, lining players up, talking to players when they're doing things that aren't, that they're not supposed to be doing, right? Make sure that you manage the game really well. As you move up, you get to do, you know, if you're working high school games, like, I would never call the game, I've done North and you might know those are two prominent basketball schools in North Carolina. They won like 8 state titles. I wouldn't call that game the same way I would call Waconia and Waconia. You just can't. Right? It's just a different set of basketball. Waconia basketball, yes, they're doing them the same. But it's just a little different. So, manage the game within the game. I don't play this box match for each other. Right? Again, it's all those teeny little things. You see, if you stick it, get frustrated, it's big, and then you're talking to me. Do all those things. If you can't do it, I'll put it in a bunch of control on this phone, and I'll put it in a jersey, or in a bumper, whatever it is. I'll follow. And then you notify the court, say, this is happening. Talk to your partner about it. Okay? If there's out of bounds play, you can walk home and say, hey, you want 55 to 45. Each other really hard, let's keep it on. Right? That's the game management. And then you've got to manage your coaches. If your coach starts going sideways, you've got to calm that person down immediately. And the best way to calm them down is to not let them get to them. Right? If you're calling it the way it's written in the rules, and they're not agreeing with you, say, coach, this is what I saw. This is why I'm calling it. As a matter of fact, I'm going to get back to it. Doesn't have to be a dialogue, but you have to manage that portion of the game. Answer questions, don't have to answer comments. Okay, the coach will walk in, that was a trap. They're just going to keep walking. And you're standing right there, they walk past you to make sure you're ready. Unless it's been ongoing, and you say, coach, that's enough, that's enough. Okay? Stop, pointing, hold the glove. Coaches, try to calm. Don't let it happen. If you're communicating really well, they probably won't. So if you're going ahead of them before the ball comes to the end, just tell the two coaches to speak. Okay? Did you hear me? Hey, I'm talking to the table here with your business. Right? If you guys have a question, probably please ask. We're going to give you an answer, or we're going to get back to you. Any questions that now you know. Do that every game. Because that's how you build that goal. Because guess what? You need to have that coach 2-3 times throughout the season. Walk up to the game. It's going to take everybody else to it. Right? Because they know how to give you. You need to get the push. They hustle, they know the goals, they do all this. Right? So, do all the small things. Again, it's all the team things that matter. Okay? Make sure you dress properly. Black shoes, black socks. These are fine for some of our meetings. Left hands go to black pants. Black shorts. Undershirts should be black. You can get those mesh ones and whatever you want to wear. I wear a black one because it keeps me cool. Instead of the clean ones, don't go for it. Okay, you should. Are they wearing the gray shirts for the black one?
Huh?
Are they wearing the gray shirt for the black
one? Yeah, so it'll just be the gray. Yeah.
No, it's stripes, high school, gray with the black sleeves, collars, all different. Women's and men's. All the shirts are different. Make sure you dress your clothes. Again, just for room speed, same skin, right? We talked about community management. There's lots more to do. Front and back point coverage. We'll go over some of the set on the floor, right? The front quarter consists of everything from here that way to the end line. The half court line is not part of the front court. It's part of the back. Okay? Just a couple little things. So when a person's bringing the ball up and they step across and they're doing this, you're still in the back court and you're back like this. Is that over the back? It's not. Okay? All 3 points have to be over. I could be 2 feet and dribbling the ball in the back. Ball hasn't been dribbled in the front court at all. That's not over back court. That's not over back. So you got to keep that 10-second count on when they have it. Right? They're bringing it up the floor. They're at 5, 6. They're here. Dribbling the back court. Go back. 8, 9, 10. Oh, 10. It's a 10-second violation. All 3 points. 2 feet and a dribble ball. Hold the ball, that's 3 points over. Okay? So just make sure that it's the third in the front court. And they get really close, they do this. They step on the line, they bring the ball over. If they step down and up, that's not what they got. So just know front court, back court. Stands for the ball. Those are the 3 things you need to know. Again, your areas of coverage are going to be different. Coming up on the floor. I try to break the court line into thirds. So my middle third is going to be obviously being here all the way. So 1, 2, 3. Try to be when the ball is nearing you. There's only going to be 2 of you. So don't be straddled. If you're the trail, you don't want to be right here and just watch the play. Because the trail's responsibility is everything. So if I stand here, go that way, go all the way up, that is the lead's primary coverage area. And the trail has everything else. So if I'm out here and the kid's dribbling the ball and they get close to guarding, I got to start that count. Right? They're here. They start moving, they go all the way out there, I can't be right here. You can. But if there's a foul, you get more credibility when you're closer to the ball. So you're going to come all the way up and still count on me. Maybe you drop all the way to 1. That's still your count because you're not going to give it up to your partner. You have to know your partner with. It's 3 teams on the floor. Okay? Red, blue, official. Know where your partner is. Know what they're calling. Know what they're looking for. So you each have areas of coverage. So once the ball drops into there, now I don't even watch the ball. I start picking up all these screens, right? I'm coming over here and trying to set a screen. I do this, that's it, right? So you got to pick up the off-ball stuff. Use your peripheral to see where the ball is. It's more for the lead than it is the trail. Leads are, listen, you got a lot of room on this end line. A lot of schools you don't. It could be 3 feet and then it's a wall, okay? So as the lead, you're just going to be opposite of the trail. Trail on the near side, you're going to be far side. Right? This is my area. I'm going to go a little deeper, a little wider. Use depth and width to get your vision there. If I move in a little close, I'm standing right here, it's not helping me see the bigger picture. If I go back, right? And then when the ball is in the trails, up at your area. already stepped up all over here, removing picks and all those other things. Anybody have any questions? No? Okay. I need to make sure that you know what you're looking at for your privacy. So, back here, there's all kinds of guidelines that you should be looking at the bottom of the list. We'll put you guys out in the numbers of the new round, see what's up. Again, two-man philosophy. Constant motion. Ask about the new constant motion. Going to be counted. Not on contact. And now on all the calls. Contact. Okay? So something. Should have said. That's that big man's are they gaining an advantage by doing what they're doing? If they're too big over the ball, that's that screen good, and then I pop my knee, now you're in the knee. That's a problem. Okay? So just make sure that you see the contact. You know, pop, or block, or charge, whatever, advantage that you get. Again, National Federation High School League rules are what most communities suggest as well. There'll be some in-house rules that you've got to have. I'm one of those rules. Maybe four or five minutes, and each kid has to play a 5 minute round, whatever it is. Just normally would be your house rules. But the National Federation High School League. Buy it online, do it through your book on your phone, whatever you want. Register with us, we'll get a report of your book, and we'll get a Fox 4 person. Not that the missus, they got you right.
Yeah.
Of course, the missus is not.
Yeah.
A Fox 4 is a good one. Again, you just need your man, two-man philosophy. Work with your partner, communicate. Communicate. I can't stress that enough. Because you're going to be, even if you don't issue any more application, you're still going to have to communicate. Right? You can't text the message to the coach. This is what I got. Sorry. No cell phones, put that stuff away. Don't have that. That shows, it just gives the impression that you do not need to look at the community. Right? Your parents, everybody knows that you're at 7 in the morning. 8:10, 8:12. It's okay. Take a break. I officiate now. I started for as many reasons why I started. But for me, officiating, you get to get away from everything that's outside of the house. Okay? It's chaotic. It's the world. This is chaotic. This is where I have to live. It's fun. So if you're having fun, join us. That helps to be go that way. There's times where you can't be out and you can't be doing things, right? Because there's some serious moments in the game. And all games are their most important game you can play that day or that night. Right? Parents, grandparents, people come into lots of good stuff. Do a good job. Because you're representing your community. Your school sometimes. Right? Like, you're building your resume. And if you stick with this, when you actually go to the platform, like a legitimate job, not that this isn't, but you can make this a job. But they like to see that, this person is a basketball person. Guess what? You dealt with diverse populations, adverse situations, you know how to handle people. Right? So they're going to see that that's leadership quality skills that they're going to be wearing. Again, no rules, right? You've got to go to the rule book. When you register with us, you get a rule book. When you register with the high school, you get a rule book. When you register with the NCAA, you get rule books. Every year, you have to take a test. And all three of us black. Every year, you have to register, you can do it every year. So again, if it's something that you like, you'll be one. And knowledge that you have, right? So now you gotta put the two together. So when you become an official and you do the sport, you still playing that same sport, you can be better later. You've seen it through different set of eyes. And you've seen things that you can go, oh, man, that's all okay. And you can be the voice of reason on your team. Because you get a coach that's going, you know, hey, coach, I got this, okay? Walk on the officials, and you can do that. And you can be that communicator, that buffer between, you know, the coach that's starting to lose it a little bit. When you're being that captain, it's on the floor. When I started my first sport, I started with baseball. And the way I started was, I was playing against my buddies, and I had a 1-2 count, and it was clearly going to hit me, and we just saw it right here in college.
Sometimes it gets kind of tricky if you're busy working hard here. That's why I ask the trail to be down. Because if you're busy working, there's something happening all of a sudden, the ball gets kicked, and you're here watching this, and it goes out of bounds. That's got to be you blowing your whistle. If you're busy working, the trail can help out. But this should be you. And if you didn't have it, right, you just go, boop, out of bounds, hey, help. Just look right at your partner and you know which way is it. Is it red or is it blue? Right?
And then this far side is also out of bounds. Everything out here is out of bounds, that's true. Because then if you shoot this in the red, the point shooter goes up. I stay with that shooter up, down, and wait. And I never sit with the 3-point main basket as they lead. You just don't. Okay. So
do it correctly to the height and how high the feet can be, right? And then whatever direction the ball goes, you're going to become a huge shredder. Probably 99 out of 90. Every once in a while, the ball may scoot all the way down to the corner. My partner made their way right over to him. And they have a 2 gigs to go back. He's going to be in control. I'm going down to the lead. But for the most part, it's either going to be one way or the other. And you're going to be in control. So you can set on the other side. Or you set on the other side. And you're going to be in control. So just make sure that you're in control. Like I said, once a season, that play goes all the way down there, but it's going to go down there. When you score a mistake, I'm going to talk about bringing the ball on the floor. If they're walking the college, walk them. If they're hustling, they're fast breaking it, and they're passing. Again, I'm getting older, but it's still staying fast. I don't want to be straight line going to play. So I let them go passing, and then I can step out onto the floor. So if they're going straight to the basket, and I'm going to be leaving, I'm flying, but I know I can't get to my spot. I'm not going to be able to get there. I'll just stop getting between the two players, right? Ball angle, defender. I can see that. Make sure you don't get trouble. The more people come, you'll do it. And we don't feel it, but then you can have to do it. Okay, I can see it. And then finish my run. And I'm settled that way, right? You get down and great. Most of the time, you may have one or two fast breaks with the opposition. And that's it. Come up to the door. Again, it's just one nation that so if you have two questions, you can answer those. With the balls and the defender, you've got the ball. Right? So if I'm in trail, you can dribble. I can't drain you. Stay right where you're at, so I can't drain you. Just taunting. Right? Keep dribbling. I can't really see what's going on with them. So I either got to make them move that way. So a three-person, this is where a three-person, that's why I can't still, I can break down here. Because now my lead's going to shoot across my trail, which was my slot. But in two-person, I like coming here anyway. I don't have the trail. I'm fine. But if you can see that they're getting set up, go that way. Maybe you can see that going down. Out onto the floor, right? And he's close to the guard. I'm getting my count. Another rule. What constitutes close to the guard? 6 feet. So when does a 6 feet start? So if he's, go ahead back, right? That's about, it's a little more than 6 feet. If he reaches his hand out, is that when we get our count? It's not. So again, that's probably wrong, but it's front foot to front foot. That's the closely guarded 6 foot measurement. If they're both standing squared up, and both feet are the front feet, it's like this. So if they're back and they do this, and the coach's like, where's the count? It's not 6 feet. Here. Yeah, I'm inside 6 feet, but it's front foot to front foot. And if they're not close to that, that's your signal. You're like here. As soon as he gets close, hang there, go ahead. And I'm like here. If he drops off, then I go like that again. And again, it's dribble or help. So a person can truly hold the ball for 12 seconds without being a 5 second. Because they can give the ball, hold it for 4 seconds, dribble for 4, and pick it up and hold it for 4 seconds. You never get a violation. Make sense? So just again, rule book, get in it. Hopefully you guys purchase one or you can use it. Again, call it moving purpose. There's a reason why I'm moving. And sometimes the players will just go right to where you're at. Right? You settle in, you come right on your spot, I gotta just move. Don't mean to do this. Right? We're not doing that. Just move a couple steps, and you're up, and I can see between these players. Right, thanks, guys. Again, in transition, when the play moves, you gotta be ready to go. Again, you'll know the style of play. If you're a perimeter shooting team, you're probably gonna be up high with 1-1. Right? So, on shots, when the shot goes up, the trail, the responsibility becomes all the pushes in the back. So I like to move right up to the 3-point line if I have to. Again, don't worry about putting time before you go. Maybe you guys might be able to still put it on your drive, but again, you're cleaning all this up because the lead is watching everything up and high, right? But even on, if I'm going up, the lead's watching the hips are up and the trail has to help with the feet, right? I get the ball, I go here, and then I switch. Whoa, that's a trap. Right? The lead may not see that because there's a person step behind or trying to move the position, right? So again, on shots, you have all backside. It pushes in the back, shoves over to the side, whatever it is, be ready to position. And then when there's a turnover, bust it down the floor. If they're going fast, you gotta hold it really quick. Anyone else go? You gotta pace yourself. Some guys will do 10 games in a game. I don't. It doesn't make sense. It's not good for the team, so that's why I'm glad you guys are here to help spread the news out more. Free throw coverage. So when you're lining free throws, you can be on whatever side you're going to be, right? Two person is table side, trail will stay table side. He's going to go opposite the table with 2 person. If you have a 3 person, slot, the trail. Right? But if you're 2 person, you have a ball, and you go over the right. Sometimes the table's right here. You don't have to switch every time. If I have a ball, I just turn around, you have to right hand side. I hold super shots. The trail should be helping set the ball. Right? That being said, my responsibility are those 3 players on that side. Trail has the shooter and these 2. Because there's no longer something down here. They got rid of that because people are getting rid of it. Not many people are coming. So it's those 3 players and you can sneak up. Pick up this guy. He's got a lot of work on him. Because he has 1, 2, 3, 4. Plus, the meaning to be players. Right? They can't break the line until the ball is not in. Right? And there's a maximum of 4 defensive players. 1, 2, 3, 4. And 2 offensive players. If the offense chooses not to have a lead, they can drop back. This player can take that spot or stay in the spot, but they can't add another. Cannot. You can only have 4 or 2. And these perimeter players, if you cannot cross this line, the 3-point arc, until it hits the rim. So if they take a shot, you see these guys come flying in before it hits the rim. That's a violation. Violation. You can say 12 already. Same with the shoot, right? The shooter can't, after they shoot, they can't step across until they hit the rim. So again, good eye contact. So when I go to the court, my knee is administering all that stuff on the top. You can't even know until it's going to hit the rim. So probably, my coach is going to practice how to line up. So be the basketball in Madison. You've got to work. Again, throw-ins, you got the con, make sure to step back. If you're, doing this, you get to stay right there and then bounce the ball to him. You want to toss it to him, and you can hand it to him. You just step back and get your con. Right? You can say it verbally, but most of us don't. Although, we'll see that. Hey, is that true? Right? What you're watching for, it's a set where they can't move, which is normally on the sideline. Sometimes on the inline, if they just made a pass, they can move. So if they take their step, again, it's a 3-foot box. They go like this, and that's a violation. Right? But if they go here, take one step, and then one jump pass, right? So just know the difference between them running to pass that, and then just taking one step and jumping. It's not about that. And then the other fish is like everybody else. So, again, no one loves the games. You guys should be okay with that. Right? Just make sure nobody's pushing in the bottom of the hands. Okay, proper mechanics. That is your selling point as an official. Right? You have good mechanics, they're going to believe. Don't have a weak whistle. I wish I had brought my whistle. A weak whistle game. No, it should be sharp. Because everybody's looking. You're going to get it. You got this. That's a foul. That's a violation. Right? See the play from start to finish. Start, see it develop, and see the end of the play before you put air in your whistle. Unless it was like crazy contact and stuff. Stop. Right? But see the play from start to finish. It's called a patient listen. Because if I can make a layup, and I get bumped a little bit? Yeah, there's bumping in the basket. I'm going to get touched with it. If it's here, nigga, and you can hear it, yeah, that one will come. But if I'm going up and I just get bumped a little bit, basket's good, I'm going the other way. Right? I'm trying to get a rebound, and somebody from behind taps the ball on me and has it bumping. Call it out of bounds, right? Out of bounds, red. Because blue knocked the ball out of bounds. More so, he probably bumped the player, which made the ball look like I did. At that point, we're just going to give it and save that one for later. And then that's upper level stuff. But what you guys are doing, what grades did they work here together?
Fourth, fifth, and sixth.
Oh, yeah. You guys should be fine. There may be some classes. Again, two-handed sessions, right? 25, 10, 1. If it's just 5, then it could be different. Because you're going to the table, then maybe left, you're left, you're left, you're right. 25, 15, 51. So practice this. You practice your time. Like before you leave, you're in your mind. All the way until the 0 point of the time. So 421. As soon as it gets to 420, I just put my head down and I count. And when I look up and I get to 10, it should say 420. And you look over. Right? Because you can count with both hands. And then you have a clock down to the clock system. Smidging off you. But that way, looks like you're into the game or something that you're doing. Mechanics that you're selling, right? You have all the different parts. You have a charge, you have a block, you have a hold, you have a push, you have a hit, you have a kick, trip. There's all kinds of things. So make sure that you're knowing those. If it's important, make sure that's how you communicate. And you want to do a spot follow. To slow down. So when I have a foul, if I'm the lead, and I gotta go to the table to report, I know we're shooting, right? So took it to the rack, foul, count the basket. We're shooting one, right? Say that before you go. You can give up your limiting interest as well, right? Boom, counting, I got a hit, one shot. to during the day. Ignore them as best you can. But no, no, this is not going to be a good idea. Some things that will trigger this threat. And if they have a good feeling, they should leave the alone. And if you just explain it the way you saw it, and they say, well, that's not the way I saw it. Well, you've got to agree to disagree with it. This is what I saw. So I'm going back. Okay, so just be matter of fact what you do in the issue. If you make a good job, if you don't know what happened, you tell them your partner, the community. That is also one of the best things you can do, because that gives everybody a second, especially you, your partner, to talk about what happened, what are we having, what are we doing, and the folks do it, and they're okay. And they got together to talk about it. This is what I want. The folks that you, no, we're not. We got to call back. And then show the things that we're doing. Because that's all about it. And again, player safety, number one. It's the number one most important thing. If there's players doing rough stuff, call that, call it right away. And there's a couple of philosophies. They're like, well, we don't call it. The game will go quicker. Actually, the game usually takes longer than you don't, because now you're going to have to start talking about fouls. The game is rougher and it's harder to appreciate as rough well played the game. It just is. So, the first 5 minutes of the game, that's when you get everything in the rule book into the game. Right? Get it all in play right away. Don't let players do this. Don't let them push. Don't let them back people down. Don't let them do this. Don't. Call it. They'll make the adjustments if they don't. And you'll have a free throw contest. The game's going to take an hour to come to the game's regardless. So how do you want to referee? You want to referee a hard, flat, chunky, rough game, or you want to have a game that has flow, that they can move up and down? Because a game that lasts an hour may feel like it lasts 2 hours. A game that lasts an hour may feel like it only lasts half an hour. Yeah, because you call it the way the rules are written. Makes sense. If there's one thing, literally call it the way it's written. Call it the way they want it to be called. Because every conference that I work for is just really different. You know, in some games, the players are better, stronger, faster. They can play through a little bit. Go to a junior college, they're a little sloppy, a little ragged, way fast, running like they can. Holy cow, but it's just out of control. So you call it a little bit. And again, city game versus the suburb, we can't buy a college. Just because of the style of the it's just that's the way it is. So if you guys are figuring that out, get your way up to that. Again, all the rest of this, the guy who's talking about what we need to be in our team set up, right? I'm pulling the rules, so that's you can go ahead and look. There is one, if you look at the throwing spot, guy, right? Because everybody thinks that if it's inside the three-point arc, then it always goes to the end line. And that is wrong. It goes from the corner,
straight up to the elbow, and then around for a semicircle, and then back down to that corner. So it could be right here, where it's a foul, it's a non-shooting foul, we're down in the bonus. So when I have a foul right here, I'll say, I have a hole. White 25, ball's going to be on the side. I'll go record it. My official is replacing me. He knows right where it's going to be. That's a little teeny quicky quiz that you give to everybody that's following. So they can expedite themselves. And your partner can help expedite the game. So when I'm done recording, 25, I have a hole. I turn around. Let's go right down to my lead position, and I'm all set to go. Right? So, give the information. And when you're calling calls, don't be nervous.
Don't ever follow. Have the lead and run out. You got to fall, right? We're here. You blow your whistle. All kinds of guys, you can see. Five, let's take off. You got to follow. Right? Five. Sometimes you may even get just a number. And you look back, all of a sudden they all already moved. You're like, oh, man. They all have the same ponytail. They all have the same haircut. They all have the same style. So see it. Get your number right away. Get that number right in there. Don't need to be in the movie as a position. Like, ever, baseball. Calling balls. Calling the movie. Basketball is a basketball position. They're watching you. So, again, no more on the balls from the field. There's a full mark set on the side, and there's a bunch of them coming in. So, put the ball in play where it's supposed to be. Because if you go, if there's a foul here, and you give the ball to him there, as opposed to here, that's a huge advantage, right? You take it from 8 feet to 20 feet away from that. That's huge. So make sure you put a move in the right box. My leg can go. Let's check this out. That's a little bit of information. So we have to follow some of this in the back just as well. Points of emphasis, that's towards the back. We talked about the rough play, don't let it happen. The game's got to get cleaned up. When it's a clean game, it's way more entertaining for everyone, and it's a better game to appreciate. And if the game is really good to communicate with the players and the coaches, you can do it for fans again every once in a while. You know, try to limit your interaction with the fans. You guys are often on your company to know this, so people are like, hey, what's up? But the question is, work. I was just, anytime I come into a gym, I say, hi there. And we go, hey, what's up? And then I just go to my spot. Now I'm going to start watching them one on. Start to make a move and then I stop, Now, in 3 seconds, it's back on conversion positive. So if it was
here, I'm looking, you got one, two, you start talking to that person right away. In 55, you have 2 seconds, go move, move, move. Just put the whistle right to the side top. They start making a move, but then they stop and they look, now it's 2 seconds. But if they take it to the basket, it's not. Okay? So, because you're going to have to go, that's 2 seconds, that's 2 seconds. And if I don't have the ball and I get in, I'm here, and I'm standing here, you just trying to get it. You can say, hey, you can talk it out. That is not out. It used to be. That is out. Right? Me just going like this doesn't constitute. They can go here, and then go back here and do it again. You can go here, right? 2 feet have to be out of the team. If not, you can set. Just keep talking. That's a communication. Right? Straight up, almost. So even if it's a better, goes like straight up to the block, they go straight up, and then how about if they're jumping into them, trying to get the shot, and hit the deck? It's not. It's not. It's going to be a problem if you're going to have to do it. But this is not. Now, if I jump at the very first level, I'm going to do that. If that's a problem, that's a problem. So, know the difference of very well. Because a lot of the times, when the kid goes up, you have a player coming in, and then you get there, and you answer the questions and do this. Did they leave? Because you can watch them, see the intent on players, either their body language or their eyes. You have to see that intent. And the way I think of it, in all sports that I do, is when I start to officiate, I get a look in both ways, each of them, one of them. It starts with five. You get down to the other coach. You go to the ball, and you travel, right? I'm just building a working Rolodex. I have some semblance of what they do and where I need to be in position to get a good call. Does that make sense? You know, try to work. You're going to work. So that's it's done in well. So try to use that as a game. You know, it's a baseball game, they're using all those balls. You know, soccer, they keep violating the same foul, you can part of it. The constant infringement of the rules. Like, hey, two, that's the second one now. That's your second one. They know what you're talking about. If he does that same violation, common foul, I'm going to encourage you, I'm going to talk to you. Walk with the coach, coach has constant infringement of the rules. You did it 3 times, talk to me after the second one, and you did it. Take care of that. Come back to it. Again, kicking, it's got to be an attempt. If I'm trying to hit the ball and I kick the ball back, that's not easy. I'm going to try to hit the ball. Very well, pass it. You pass my kick, it's from here down. But if I'm standing here and you throw the ball off, I'm like, that's not hitting the ball. Or if I'm moving this way, I'm inside, and I move it off, and you pull it off, that's not hitting the ball. That's the intention for the good out of it. Okay, so just be aware of those things. Talk about 3 seconds, close the guard at 5, it's 6 foot, front foot to front foot. 3 second back foot. 5 second on the side, out of bounds to front. You don't have to worry about basketball movement to go to excessive swing at the time is a violation. Better get the ball in this. Because it'll happen when you get the big kid on that 6th grade team and he's playing a bunch of those shorts that are good, but just because he's taller, that's what his help is for. Just blow that right away, that's a violation. Now if he hits somebody, you could eject him. That's a flight to pop. Above the shoulder, you give him the face with an elbow. That player's down. That's a closing up. It's a flagrant one. So, again,
and you see a player doing that immediately. Even if it's just by themselves, they start doing all this like, hey, you can blow your whistle and still be able to get the ball. Like, hey, you can just not swing the ball. Talk them out of fouls. You have that, you have that right to do that. Talk them out of it. Again, try to use your whistle. Have your hand on your hand at the top of your hand. Especially in the paint, those are being sprayed out. Watch your hands, get your knee off it, whatever, it's 2 points, that's a foul. Okay? Again, automatics, it's an automatic, so make sure that you're good. Talk about the length of the formation. Well, again, there's a list of things why I do like the shading. I've got to travel the country. I've got to meet a lot of different people. And I've seen quite a bit of fun of doing this. Because I've been doing this a lot. If you can get to that top level, that's a great opportunity for you to be a professional fisher. Or if you want to be an international, or the Olympics, things like that. This can take you to a lot of places. You can meet a lot of great people to do. Because some of the best parts of being an official is that people go out and use them. Get some chicken wontons and beverage. We talk about those. And we'll have, like, groups. When we used to work out here all the time, we would go to Glencoe, Sibley's, all these places out in the middle of nowhere. But we'd meet at that chain house. It's a B-Dub and that Applebee's right there. There'd be a group of us like, here's the cut up. It's all like it. Folks coming in. Hey, that's how you really get good. And if you do get a chance, like some of the older gentlemen, you could work the lower level high school games. So I employ some of you guys that are older to register at the high school game if you plan on doing upper or higher level. So if you register at the high school game first, you take care of all your certification, and you're like, I could still do some new stuff. So you register at MYAS. You register at the MYAS as a high school certified official. It's advertised. And you won't have to do all these certs on our side because all staff are all. All your certifications slide over into the MYAS. Except for a sports specific youth basketball rules module. That's the thing you have to do. You have to take the high school test, background check, all of your certifications. Take it, and then all of that stuff. So, again, what generally you guys want to, you know, look at an employee to go ahead and work some high school. And you could do like the freshman can handle fun for the seniors. I was in America, but I don't know. There's a lot of schools where you can go do that. As long as your job. You're still part of the game, right? Because after you stop playing competitive sports at a high level of your, in your mind, that you think you're good, you may not be good anymore, but I can still rep, okay? You're still part of the game. It is a great exercise because it goes down. But by the time you're done, you're sweating. Like, shall you do the thing? Keeps you structured, it gets you, like, especially high school students, structured together. How many 16-year-olds are you? My son was 16, he was going to get a job. All right, here's a student. Oh, I'm going to get work. He said, I can do it, I can do it. He said, you're a great student, you need to work. So we got a job at home, like, stocking shelves and stuff. That lasted a month. This makes great to remember. Because he's got it. Finn at 6 a.m. He's got school, he's got practice underneath. He's got to come home. He then took a shower and come home. There was no time. That's how I got him into fishing. Because he was making $8 an hour. How many hours did he have to work? heel next to the heel, right around the heel. And just go sideways every time something doesn't go away from well from what's in there. So they're part of our trusted coaches platform. We have trusted officials. We have assignments that you guys can work with. And you should be running to the left and side. Hey, runs to west and north. So from here all the way to Monticello. And Jerry does here down from here. Okay? So there's plenty of opportunity. And it gives you guys a structured schedule from our student life. Because that's most important. And I can tell you, chase your dream of an athlete. Chase that dream until you know you can achieve it. Chase it. Because that's who doesn't want to. Not going to be able to do it, yes. Because it becomes your life, right? It's your team, right? Your body. So if you like to fish, you like to run, you like to do other things, being a professional athlete isn't what it's all about. So, chase that dream. Chase it. You're a good baseball player, you're an athlete. I coach baseball for 10 minutes. High school varsity. Like, you guys all chase your dreams. But I got a bunch of those dudes on fire. It's funny too. They have a blast. You can $75 for an hour and a half. Sign me up. Let's go. So again, it's a good way to be a part of the game and get back. Maybe you'll grow up and you'll start coaching with you. You'll be that coach. How am I going to handle this team? I wasn't the most popular. I didn't work with them. Instead of just yelling at them. Right? So it's changing. The tide's changing. Does anybody have any questions? I know I said a lot. If you have a question that you know the answer to, but somebody else has been very much asked, go ahead and ask. That's what we're here for. Nothing. Again, uniforms, you buy them online. Best place to go is General Sports. Right over by the Adina Sports down there, the Great Mountain Park. They have everything there. Even if you went there just to try it on, because a lot of you young guys and gals are going to, you're going to grow stuff. So you can try it on, but okay, the medium could be well pushing. I'll start lifting, you know, swole, and have to go to a lot, whatever. So try it on, and then go online. And you can get some stuff online. Go to a rep, Schmitty, officials, Jerry Davis, do not buy anything. You see the warehouse. Those people in the car, they just go up and they're like 5 shirts. They look at a picture and go, that's the one. What then? That's what you're getting. John, I'm telling you, it's not good. So, fight and rep on the way to sell it. Sports out of the way. Dixon. Chills, they won't have any of the stuff that you need for pictures. You gotta go to specifics. So, and then the sports is close to it. I was over there the day I went. Again, if you want to sign up to be an upper level for something, maybe in the middle of the season. Okay, I'm trying. Our registration will always be open. You know, high school, but you need to see second and eighth grade. I don't think you want to. We'll get you in the sign. You just got to take all of those certifications and get ready to go. Again, have fun with this. Have fun. If you're having fun, and not all the time is it going to be fun. No, it's not. Basketball's, I call them dynamic individuals that you deal with at my level. Right? They're going to be 6'9". You just got to be able to communicate with people. The better you are at communicating. So, for some of you guys, if you're all kind of shy right now, nobody's asking any questions, I would implore you to go to a Home Depot around town somewhere. Go into a club, any one of the stores, say hi to every person you walk past. Just say hi. See what happens with that conversation. It could just be, hey, I'm here. That's it. It could be, hey, you work here. Wearing that own shirt at my Home Depot, right? You're like, no, I don't, but maybe I can help you. Right? I mean, that's how you're going to learn how to be a really good communicator. do it. If you guys are kind of shy, just do it. I post one something, I'm like, dude, here's the future list. I need you to ask about a window replacement. It's got a triple pane with the swinging thing and all that. And he's like, just go ask. So he was in there for 20 minutes talking to this guy. And it was more educational about the window than anything. And then he had the community for the rest of the time. Right? Because he's the internet, like Facebook junk. Go talk to these people. Because that's part of your job. Talking to these people. Yes.
In the rare instance where there's a buzzer beater shot, who takes the call? The leader of the trail gets inbounds and shot from half court.
Primary area coverage. So the PCA, primary coverage area. So if it's in my area, it's going to be me up and down, right? And you got to hear. You know, we don't have replay at this level, so is it off before you hear it or see the home or see the clock? Right? And you're gonna have that. That's, you have to be watching everything that's going on and paying attention to the clock just as well. Right? So there's lots of action going on in the past. Again, whoever's PCA is, that's where it's going. Right? And if you need to get ready to talk about it, great. Because it could come from that way over there, it's going to be the lead that has it. And they're going to go, hey, basket's good. And clearly it probably wasn't. And then you go, hey, I thought that the ball was out of their hand. But once the ball leaves their hand and the horn goes off, that ball still has an opportunity to go into the basket. Right? It's not like hockey or soccer. 1 second left, get it. Still got 3 yards to travel. Horn goes up, ball's in the net. Basketball? Back. 2, 1, shot goes off, and goes in. That's good. Okay, we get that movement. Super important. You register with us, you get a movement. You register with high school, you take a movement. You register with us, you get a high school just as well. Land and move. Because I don't use the one that clips to the shirt. Because a lot of shirts don't have it, the t-shirt doesn't, so they're going to be able to do it. Okay? Right up to the top, so it's just brand new. Any other questions? You got to look good? Derek, you have any questions of me?